I wonder where that is.
Confused.
That's why I'm thinking about just getting that lower shirt, because this 2X is like short. I don't know. But I'm about to lock back into the second game so I can get off the. About to get the second game out of the way so I can get off the game. Yeah, that's cool.
We're situated about 8 miles west of New York City at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. A few minutes ago, the hometown Jets were introduced to this sellout crowd, and it's a roar that could be heard across the river in Manhattan. They're set to go as their Jets will match up with the Baltimore Ravens. The first 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off?
Last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max protect, keep everyone
in the ball,
or maybe just one or two receiver routes in order to try and keep your quarterback upright.
On second down, it's Hall, and he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
Why does this mean you're in the same places
and not allowing any lanes to open up?
That's on the string.
It's hard.
Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a third and three. On fourth down, punt coming from Braden Mann.
Weird.
They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And taken right at the 35. Now a hit and a loose football. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And he takes it to the house. It's a fumble recovery for a Jet touchdown.
He's backing up.
And now, as with every potential turnover, we're going to take a second look at this just to make sure.
And then he puts a girlfriend in front of
him. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble.
Oh my God, you see the fumble?
Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Off the play fake.
Jackson.
Well, he's going to take a shot right away.
Perfect.
Team and it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart. And the Jets will take over here at their own 14-yard line.
What is that? It was a blessing, a rain, or a tornado.
Three and five is where they sit on the year. A very uneven start.
Like, who can buy me some new players?
At the halfway point of the season. CD, do you see an avenue where they can still be a playoff
team,
or is that ship sailed?
Well, since you took me to the nautical side, I'm going to try and keep up here, because to me, this ship is about ready to pull out of port. These next couple of games are absolute must-wins for them. Now, if they can win a couple, get to 5-5, maybe they start believing in themselves.
But a loss here,
that would move them to 3-6. And if that's the case, well, that boat is going to head out to the harbor with them still on the dock.
They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
The goal of a wild screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
What do you mean you'll beat him? He just said he'll beat him. Meanwhile, dude, you get on the ground.
Bring out an extra defensive back here on third. They go play action with Lawrence.
Left
side, it's complete.
Hey, my daddy.
What?
I need something to eat.
All right, hold on. Let me get this game real quick. Hold on, bro.
Come on.
You gonna keep going to it. Bro, hold on. Let me play this game real quick.
Simple of a throw as they'll have all game.
And good for everyone. Good for his completion percentage. Good for the receptions for the receivers. But you know how they work on that. They have footballs with no laces. So as soon as
at
you
least,
get the snap.
At least he wasn't that stupid to run. The other people
his fifth touchdown.
Like he wasn't even scared. He was scared. But he wasn't scared to run out.
Well, we've said it many times.
Yeah.
He's always a threat to go the distance.
Meanwhile, this dude over here playing his broken
hands.
On
this occasion, he did just that.
But he's definitely the guy that makes his offense go when you're an RB1 running back.
And then she's going to become her whole family and you won't be the
man. Everyone's going to be the home run run this Saturday. Once you get that opportunity and that opening,
and then he's going to be wondering, like, why am I
extra point by Nagar is up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. On the return, Devin Duvernay.
And then people say we just
cross the 25.
That's why.
And that's true.
You got up and play today. Let's go.
Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should
come
be
on, yeah.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see when they decide to do a play call. Because
come on,
a one-play drive where you throw an interception.
What is your little white thing?
A lot of people think the very next time out, run the football. Don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action.
I think maybe you go play action. Show your quarterback. Get a little confidence in him and let him fling another one.
Because he's just wiggling and jiggling.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second in the yard.
Wiggle.
They go play action with Jackson.
Why would you do that?
And he'll be taken down across the 50.
Why would you do that, though?
Territory.
Look, I'm going
to
give
some credit to the big fellows, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes. Because you got to give the receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good act.
And this is caught inside the 5.
Can I look at my
take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. A big play there with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game.
Okay, basically.
Tucker with the extra point.
No, basically, the person with the green one that's running right now, he literally was walking the person that can't walk.
As they kick it away.
And the dinosaur came, and he was pushing the person, that one that can't walk, that's in the wheelchair, towards the dinosaur. Let him go in that game.
Offense taking over for their next possession. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on
the next drive.
All right, let's hold the zone drops. Good shit, bro. That's smart. All right.
Season and the Jets get the quick strike touchdown. Extra point behind the goal is up and good, and that makes the score 14-7. kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Oh, the return is Duvernay. And he's going to be out of bounds here right at the 20-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed. And that's a great spot to be in.
But I beautiful.
Love if it ended today, and I'll guarantee you, that's
a 7 days, not a day.
Heard me.
It's not ending today.
Right.
So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot with their number one in their
conference. Oh,
take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. So, Charles, you know, offensively, this group really playing at a high level. 7-0. We're still a long ways from discussing a potential unbeaten season, I think. But to use a golf expression, no blemishes on the card.
Daddy, can I get a solo?
Hold on. Zach, get him some chairs, please.
This was on speed dial, but I do think that they're going to have to start answering questions about this start if they can
win. Give me some solo,
damn game real quick.
Great job. They kept people off of it, allowed him to run free and make the hit on the runner.
Filled the gap nicely, kept him to just a 1 yard gain. Play action. Now Jackson. Now he's flushed out right. He's got his man. It's Andrews. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. We knew he was close to the line of scrimmage.
Bad for me, eh?
When you see him in that position, you think he's become a
bad for me, eh?
He's starting to react towards the line of scrimmage. They can often throw it over your head.
Bad for me, eh? Is your mind still?
The New York offense taking over for their next possession.
Daddy, can you give me, can I put my pants out for me?
Last time. See if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
Cut on, podcast.
Bro, wait. So far. No one gets behind you.
I already told you I'll do it. Why are you asking that?
They did. Let's see how they adjust.
But you already know he's going to the way. Second and
eight. Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged.
You got to go to the bathroom.
But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play. They go play out to now. Lawrence. He's
going to
watch this thing right
on field. Yo, Peter, you're getting fucking victimized, bro. What the fuck is going on?
Inside the 30 now, first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 50 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they move the ball with relative ease.
Right back to him on first down. And he's eaten up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top 5, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway because that's your strength.
Second and 9, Lawrence. That will be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up the 3rd down.
You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it up to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
On 3rd down, Lawrence. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. More problems here on 3rd down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on 3rd down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
So a nice kick there as they add 3 to the lead.
And from what I've seen so far, Brandon, I think they've been the better of the two teams here in the first half. So even though you want the touchdown, I think that's a nice job there to put 3 points on the board.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Set at the line for this next drive. They find themselves down 17-10 as they come up on first and 10. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Hands it off out of the gun. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Thank you. reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And he takes it all the way down to the 15. It's a big play there for Baltimore.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
From the red zone now, here's Jackson on first down.
Good pick.
Are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one where you are really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points.
You played that shit perfect.
You're thinking kicking a field goal and getting.
We're playing with this nigga. Come on.
We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points?
He's about to fuck around and beat you.
This could cost them.
Roster.
On first down, Lawrence, and he'll find Hall, and he's got room, and he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
And I like the idea here, get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. Three catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
Some breathing room. And they're going to have this in a great spot way down in Baltimore territory. 94 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. They'll try the left side. Paul, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage. And we're still in the second quarter.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And they're going to stop him here short of the goal line with a flag down. Well, this could set up a very interesting decision. A terrible spot for a holding call as they'll try again, but now from further back on first and goal. On play action, Lawrence. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Touchdown! C.J. Uzama, his first touchdown on the year. And the Jets find a way to stretch their lead.
Ass a day, boy.
Extra point by Nagar is up and good. And the lead now up to 14. Touchback.
Yeah. Playing ass today, boy.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And with him down two scores, he might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. As it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one.
We can't wait today.
Second and 16. Another try after the first down sack. Jackson. Looking right sideline. That's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. A big play that time through the air. 31 yards. So the line of scrimmage all the way up to midfield now as they've got it first and 10. Play action. It's Jackson. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll just get rid of it.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
From midfield now, here's Jackson. 20! And they do finally get him.
That down tackle's just gay as hell, bro.
4 seconds left, and there's the timeout. In field goal range and a chance to tack on three before intermission. Final play of the half here. It's Jackson dancing to his left, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Lamar Jackson. As time expires in the first half.
Turn up time.
They're able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Well, that was all Lamar Jackson all the time on that drive, both through the air and in the end with the touchdown run.
Yeah, how about him doing things a little bit on the reverse side there, Brandon, because he softened him up throwing the football and opened up the running lanes. And when he gets a little bit of a sliver, he's gone.
Yeah.
That's exactly what he did there.
The extra point, and that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. So we've hit halftime here at MetLife Stadium with the home team, the Jets, leading this one. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! The kick is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Wave.
Set at the line for this next drive. And they trail here to begin the second half. What's going to be a key for them to get back in the game?
I think they're right there, and I think this game is still up for the taking for them because we also have got turnovers. They had two of them in the first half, and once you start to have that, if you have three, four, or five, you know it's beyond difficult to try to win the game. Those have to be eliminated. If they take care of the ball, they've still got a shot.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. This time in the tailback, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Second and 8. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Off the play fake. Here's Jackson. Eluding the pressure right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open, you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
Now he's forced out right.
And no! The fuck? You know better, man. That shit was over.
Oh,
good job, man.
It's a touchback.
Doing dumb shit, Rob.
At the 20-yard line.
Yeah.
The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And their defense just helped them out by getting the football back on the opening drive here in the second half. And now can the offense follow through with points on their first possession?
That's a big one for them because after the work the defense has done, they've got a chance here to open up this lead.
They're going
to
snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Now Lawrence. Being chased out left. And he wisely will throw that one away. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Lawrence to throw. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Play action. It's Lawrence. Open receiver. That's Hayden Hurst, the tight end. And a six-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and four. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a third and three. Flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
After the interception, here's Jackson. And he just throws this one away.
Fuck, like a skateboard. It's like, this shit's fucking terrible.
And it brings up second down.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about
I'm almost done, Rob. I'm almost done, baby. Let daddy focus the last quarter in there.
Thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
Try the right side here. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 and the 12. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Decided to hit it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
Pronto.
On 3rd and 3. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5.
Having my way down for your last.
40 yards now on the ground.
Having my way down for your last, Pronto.
Thank you. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. A great effort there with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. Tucker with the extra point, and that will tie our game here in the third. Nothing separating these two sides. 24 our score as he sends this one away. It's a short kick taken out beyond the 20. And they're going to start this drive in bad shape as they get it up past the 30. Taken over for their next possession. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going.
On first down, it's Hall. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Well, on every play call, you realize he's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later.
Why are you playing up? Young-ass safeties. That's what you get for having young-ass safeties. You're in fucking cover four. Why the fuck are you biting on that shit? Pronto.
We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll try and run for it.
Free at last.
And he is in. Touchdown.
Free at last.
A great play there.
Having my way on free at last.
Touchdown in the afternoon.
Having my way on free at last. Pronto. Get up on my level. Get up on my level. Stay and kill us while I'm one of them. Oh, what a still are.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a seven-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. He'll get eight on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Ahead of the chains now, second and two. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 50 yards on the ground for him now on nine carries. I tell you, they didn't give it to him much for the first three quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Yeah, not sure it was
actually Emma.
Plan for him to have as few carries as he has.
Say, kill as well, I'm one of them.
As you noted, they want to ride him down the stretch. He should have fresh legs.
Jackson firing quickly out wide for Bateman. He's at the 40, past the 20, and all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Rashad Bateman, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying this game here on the fourth. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good, and we are tied here in the fourth quarter.
Too fucking hard.
Out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try.
Too hard, Rob.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48.
Okay, kill this one on one of them. Check you jumping and skipping. Let us do it. Don't worry.
For real. For them to try and snatch a victory.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one right up the gut.
So through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20.
Three on first down.
It'll set up a second and 7.
They did a really nice job there defensively. They strung the play out. Didn't give them a cutback lane. On each play, we have guys what I call our BCR players. Guys are responsible for the bootleg, for the cutback, and for the reverse. They played that one perfectly.
And rode him right out of bounds.
You burn the ring of light.
It's a tackle made at the 10-yard line.
In the sky.
When you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. Only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Hall, and he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
I have to laugh a little bit because he actually handed it off. I thought with the 2 touchdown passes he's thrown in this one already, he'd go ahead and fling and try and get a 3rd one.
Yeah, now from this spot on 3rd down, I think he'd probably throw
it
here.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about it. They won't even send in a running play here, I don't believe. I think they go ahead and try and throw it for a touchdown.
Oh, good blocking.
Touchdown, Jets. A great effort there. With his 3rd touchdown of the game, number 7.
Seeing the sky.
Extra point behind the guard is open good.
I was just seeing that one in my head.
7-point lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will
see. And I was back in my head.
And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback.
When you do that, I'll be watching TikTok.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
Yeah,
the recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown. Looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
That takes me back to when we saw with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together some more drives.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They come up on their first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Flushed out right. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
So you're on grasshopper?
Not at all, and now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, You can't have those kind of plays.
Now Jackson. Steps away to his left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Oh, he's running away, I'm sorry.
Stops the clock and let your offense catch its breath. And let's us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle, so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
Now a handoff as they run left side. They get six. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
What's now?
First down is the tackle.
Yeah.
Like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
Now a handoff looking right. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Now the Raiders use one of their timeouts. As they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game.
Aren't you so cold right now? Are you cold? I'm really cold. Oh, yes, she's so cold.
8 yards to go, 1 second down. Throwing, Jackson. Rolling to his right. And yes, he's into the end zone. So they get the late score they needed. And now the extra point can tie this thing up in the final minute. Tucker now for the extra point. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams are all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. Taking over for their next possession. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play, but if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. He's going to float this one deep right side, and that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. These are the spots, this stage of the game, where it pays to have speed on the perimeter, doesn't it?
How do you make me want to yell at me?
He may very well run by him, but in this situation, I know as a defender, I'm loosening up a couple of extra steps.
You just stand here bored or take to watch me play at me. It says I won 50, so
I'm
50.
Have a first down.
Oh, nice. What was that?
Celebration game.
Because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision, and receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
Ooh,
and they'll throw on first down to taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
Now
this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. Another try after the first down sack. Lawrence.
What the fuck?
It's caught inside the 25. And he's in for the touchdown. And in the final seconds, forget overtime. They've just has likely won this thing in regulation. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. The return is Duvernay. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. One last shot for Jackson. First down and more for Jackson. And he takes it all the way up to the 47.
Right.
Going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really spectacular.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took
I'm
us down
literally
to the
trying
last
to find
play,
an outfit
still, you're wondering,
it.
Could it happen?
Possibly.
It was a long shot.
So for the Jets, it's an important win for their postseason hopes as they at least get back to 4-5. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Buffalo Bills. Meanwhile, for Baltimore, the perfect season was apparently not meant to be as they dropped to 7-1. Things are on next week as they have a matchup in Cincinnati against the Bengals. I'm Brandon Gunn.
What a great game.
Thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Can I play me? Want to play me? He's a brother with him. I want you to be the brother with
him. Bro, you didn't let me play the game, dog.
I won. I'm really trying to learn.
Some of these contract updates.
Ow. I need to. Okay. Anyways, I'm just found. Oh my god. Do they have any mini games? I'm not going to be able to do that.